How often do you splurge on a cat toy and end up with your cat preferring to play with the plastic bag that it came in? Playtime is essential for a cat's health and well-being, also for behavior improvement. But did you know that there are some instructions for it? Well, actually, the instructions aren't for cats, they're for you. Hey guys, welcome to Furry Feline Facts, a perfect catalog of cat stats. In today's video, we're going to bring you some information on cats' playtime, best cat toys. If you're not already a follower of Furry Feline Facts, meow is the time to click the subscribe and notification bell. If you are, give yourself a round of applause. Okay, enough kitten around. It's meow or never. In our video on playtime with cats, we discussed and gave some general information, tips and tricks regarding the importance of playing with your cat. So make sure to check it out. With the way a crumpled up ball of paper, a discarded paper bag, or even a stray pen left on the desk can launch your cat into a hyperactive play session, it seems like our feline friends have perfected the art of entertaining themselves. It's true that cats have wild imaginations. It only takes a newspaper on the ground to turn it into an exciting toy that she'll bat at and chase after until she maxes out her energy reservoirs. Typically, cats enjoy playing with small objects that are light in weight and easy to flick, swat, and chase after. And whether your resident cat is a fan of chasing ping pong balls or if she prefers to solve puzzles and mazes, the toy market has a plethora of fun, exciting options. Now, the importance of toys to a cat's health is invaluable. They stimulate their mind and instincts. A toy can make cats exercise more, and it can lessen and prevent behavior problems as well as boredom. And the best part? Toys help you strengthen your bond with your cat. It seems odd that there are instructions for playtime with cats. Cats don't need that much instructing when it comes to playing. But you, human, may need a few tips and tricks. Controversial toys. It takes trial and error to figure out which toy fits your cat's needs, personality, and skills as well. For example, some cats with a shyer type of personality may shy away from large toys or ones that make too much noise. Ultimately, it may take a few purchases to find the perfect fit, but it's completely worth it. We want the best for our kitties, so we're giving you a paw up, a few tips on which toys are a big no-no and which ones are a guaranteed success. Bubbles. It seems outlandish, especially since blowing bubbles and letting your cat chase them is a popular game among cat owners. Cats do love this game, but it's not that great for their mental health. It's because playing largely feeds into a cat's hunting instinct as she indulges those needs to chase, swat, and capture. And the thing with bubbles is that your cat doesn't actually get to capture anything. The bubble just bursts before she gets to it, or it pops in her face, which is even more frustrating because you're not supposed to let the bubbles blow at her, especially directed at her face. By nature, cats are strategic creatures, and bubbles? They don't exactly give her the satisfaction of capturing prey underneath her paw after her hard work. That's not to say to give up the bubble game altogether, especially if your cat really loves it. Just be sure to never blow the bubbles at her and not at her face, and to follow the game with an interactive play session, something we'll be talking about in a minute. So be sure to stay tuned because we have some pawsome toys later. Laser toys. Laser toys are considered one of the most popular games for cats and dogs. There's just something about lasers that triggers every pet and makes them ready to jump and practically body slam into furniture in their fruitless pursuit to capture the elusive red dot. And since you can sit back in your chair, talking on the phone, watching TV, or doing something else and just point the laser, the game is wildly popular among owners. The psychological effect, according to Psychology Today, is something to be careful of. They can become frustrated. Cats chase the laser pointer's dot of light because it changes direction and speed. Cats see the moving dot as alive and worth catching. Like with the bubbles, cats never get the satisfaction of actually catching something in their paws. And since the point of interactive play is to capture prey, laser toys go against this. And what if we told you that frequently using laser toys can lead to compulsive behavior in some animals, not just cats? They can become reactive to other forms of flashing lights, not just the laser. And if you shine it into a cat's eyes, it can permanently damage their vision. The American Academy of Ophthalmology says that a laser can literally burn the retina in the blink of an eye. The natural protective mechanisms of the eye, such as the blink reflex, are ineffective against lasers with an output power greater than 5 milliwatts, and severe retinal damage may occur. even after momentary exposure. And since cats are known to be ready to chase that cumbersome dot to the ends of the earth, this could spell out danger in the form of not paying attention to their environment. If they're not focused, they could run into a wall and furniture and knock over things, which could potentially harm them or break items in your home. Since the goal is to provide a fun playtime that builds confidence in your cat and to strengthen the bond you share, if you really want to use the laser, then make sure to follow it up with an interactive playtime session. Before we get on with how to use interactive toys to wield the best results and to make your cat the happiest it can be, we'll go over some unsafe toys for cats and kittens. As a general rule of thumb, if need be, you may need to cat-proof the toys after you buy them. That means taking away anything that can be harmful to your cat, especially if you leave the toys and aren't there to supervise her playing. This includes removing all feathers, strings, ribbons, and small decorations that your cat may see as a tasty snack and chew off and swallow. Other potential harmful objects that cats view as toys include these household items: paper clips, plastic bags, string, ribbons, dental floss, pins, needles, and just about anything that may look delicious to your cat. How to use interactive toys. When it comes to cat toys, you don't need to go all out and buy a myriad of toys that your cat is likely to discard after a few experimental bats. Still, we can't resist indulging in a few cute-looking toys every once in a while. As long as you stay away from the potentially harmful types of toys and objects we mentioned earlier, you're perfect. And if you want to buy one, then the perfect toy for your cat may be the simple plastic ball, with or without the bells inside. Fishing pole type of toys, which is a long stick or rod with a length of cord attached, and a prey hanging at the end, is magnificent. Happy kitty, happy living is what I always say. The first step in learning how to use interactive toys is a little unconventional. Alright, now forget your home consisting of living areas and start looking through cat-colored lenses. Through a cat's slitted eyes, these areas are hunting grounds. The floor may not be lava as childhood games would have us believe, but the chairs, couches, and tables are trees and bushes and things you can hide behind. If your designated play area for your cat is a large open-plan room, then create this obstacle course yourself by throwing around pillows and even bags. Now, on to the action. Correctly using interactive toys involves not dangling the toys in front of the cat, hoping she'll pounce and do the rest of the work and later feel appeased. At first, your cat will narrow its eyes at it, then swat and bat at the toys repeatedly. She'll even sit up. Although it looks like your cat is having fun, this isn't how playtime should play out. Remember that playing is simulating hunting. A prey freely dangling itself in front of her, practically offering itself for sacrifice, isn't satisfying that natural predator instinct. In the face of a prey that clearly doesn't offer a challenge, your cat will just end up relying on reflexes to play instead of calculating and strategizing. And she'll end up getting annoyed and frustrated in the end. Also, make sure to never keep the toy out of the cat's reach consistently throughout the game. If your cat can't even swat her paw on what she perceives to be prey, then she'll, again, grow frustrated and annoyed. Cats want to work hard for their prey. That includes using its wicked smarts and planning as it silently stalks toward its prey, hiding and stalking on feather-like feet until it can pounce. How to mimic what prey should do? Play in a way that should feel natural to her. That means mimicking what prey would actually do in a real hunt. If you, as the prey, were out in the wild, then if you sensed a laser-focused cat focused on your movement, then you would get out of dodge, like right away. So the key is to move away from, not towards. This is another thing. Cats don't see that well when objects are moving toward her. They can even see it as a threat. Move the toy away, then guide it over to a hiding spot and let it peek out, just enough for your cat to locate its target. Freezing, as if the prey is completely standing still, is great as it excites cats. Also, don't just wave the toy around as fast as you can. Let your cat catch it again and again to enjoy the sweet taste of victory before gently getting it away to repeat the game. Catnip. It's a powerful minty herb that contains something called nepotalactone. Please check out our video dedicated to catnip, the link above. Anyway, it's a substance which causes complete ecstasy in cats. You can buy catnip, or toys which you can fill with catnip, or even grow your own. Here is a very important tip. Your cat may become immune to its effects if you leave catnip or catnip-filled toys for him or her all the time. It's important to limit catnip to once or twice a week. Make sure to buy only good quality catnip, Most of them can be found in pet supply stores or online. How often should you play with your cat? This is one of the most common questions. How often should owners indulge in some playtime with their cats for maximum benefits and results other than just having fun with your pet? The answer is 10 to 15 minutes per session, and it's recommended that sessions should be twice a day. To fit in your schedule, consider playing with your cat before you leave for the day for work or school. This makes it so your cat is satisfied and tired and will likely sleep away the day while you're gone. The second session should be in the evening or before bedtime. Something you'll thank us for if you have a particularly hyper cat who meows to announce its presence in the middle of the night. Well, there you have it, some information on playtime. I hope you learned a lot in this episode. What are your cat's favorite toys? Let us know in the comments. Make sure you subscribe to Furry Feline Facts, a perfect catalog of cat stats. And hit that notification bell to be sure you don't miss any of our pawsome content. See you next time.